is a bloom shoots up through the stony ground. There's no room, no space to rent in this town. You're out of luck, and the reason that you had to care, the traffic is stuck, and you're not moving anywhere.
For the chick exhibit, it's important that they focus on how they are in the wild, where they live, and they use a variety of zones. So we use the tree as the hub of circulation, so they're actually fed from the top down. They have places where they can nest on the upper levels. The females can get up here and the males can go below, but basically it is a recreation of an environment that allows them to behave in more natural settings.
Four years ago, we designed and built this one for them. Now this was a completely different concept that they had before. We wanted the chimps to have an area where they could be on the top, use the canopy, on the bottom, in the middle, to have little areas where they basically, this is it's well used. And see, he's hanging out at the upper level, okay? This is what they need to be able to do at all of these facilities, but they don't. They don't make them that way. And what all these guys, they're grooming, okay? You've got a male there, the three females with the baby, and they're just socializing, taking care of each other, they're bonding, you know? And this is one of their natural behaviors. So the fact that they can exhibit natural behavior inside the environment is what we all want. The more natural behaviors, the better.
Now, these little babies will grow up to be healthy, well-balanced, mature adult chimps. And they'll be able to socialize without any problems.
The baby chimpanzee can be seen here, fully utilizing the food net. He is also taking full advantage of the light holes, which provide fresh air and sunlight to better recreate a natural environment.
We cut this down. This is the main entrance to the facility here, and we put this so that little children could see the animals. And then this is a series of two different types of trees. You've got the tall trees, which is where the males go, and kind of should dominate by looking out. And then the smaller trees for the females and the babies to hang out. And this was one phase was a climbing structure. The other phase that we did at the same time was create the art museum, and this was done by children K through 12 and some university, and this was the theme of Through the Chimp's Eyes. And you can see that the chimps really, I mean, it adds another layer of enrichment that they wouldn't have normally.
Raindrops keep falling on my head, but that doesn't mean my eyes will soon be turning red. Crying's not for me, 'cause I'm never gonna stop the rain by complaining, because I'm free. Nothing's worrying me. It won't be long to greet me. Raindrops keep falling on my head, but that doesn't mean my eyes will soon be turning red. Crying's not for me.
This is Songtai's room. And Songtai is orangutan who had problem moving around. So what we did is we created places where he can actually swing and walk around. These are little breakable things that can allow him to move. And you can see him, he's sitting up in his hammock, just chilling out, relaxing, looking out the window in his summer home, his winter home.
Songtai the orangutan is now no longer depressed. He has an intricate rope system for him to get around with, and now is also being fed much better food.
Take you out of this place, someone you could lend a hand in return for grace. It's a beautiful